Diary. This is a week I'll always remember. After convincing my friends to play in the Battle of the Bands with me, we needed to work hard to get ready. The other bands were good, but that wasn't all we had to worry about. Turns out, someone was trying to ruin the competition. So along with Kevin, I was determined to find out who was responsible. That was the mystery, and that was my mission. Because the bottom line was that my friends and I wanted to play at Battle of the Bands and rock the house!
Click here to start a new game.
Diary, you'll never believe this, but I actually woke up before my alarm this morning because I'm so excited for school today. I called an emergency meeting with Courtney and Tia to convince them to participate in the Battle of the Bands with me. It'll be a lot of work getting ready, but the winning band gets a cash prize and gets to appear at the televised Summer Music Festival. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna be late if I don't hurry up and get dressed. Now, let's see. What can I wear that says outrageously glam rock star and super smart honor roll student?
Let's get Barbie dressed for school. Use the arrow keys to move her around. Walk to the closet to change your outfit. Pick a color for your top. Pick a color for your pants. Choose tops. Choose pants. Pick a color for your shoes. Choose shoes. Pick a color for your shoes. If you like what you see, click finished.
All right, I've got to get to Tia and Courtney and convince them why we have to compete. And that's why I think we should participate in Battle of the Bands.
Barbie, you didn't need to do a whole PowerPoint presentation.
But getting ready for this is going to be a ton of work. We'll need a new song,
new moves, costumes, choreography.
Did I mention the cash prize?
You did.
And did I tell you the winner gets to play on TV?
That too.
Oh. Well, Courtney, just think what you could buy with the winnings.
Ask both Tia and Courtney to be in Battle of the Bands with you. Click on Tia.
Just the person I wanted to see.
What's the good word?
That menu gives you different topics to chat about, and you can use any button that's highlighted. Try it.
Someone's looking good this morning.
Thanks. And right back at ya.
Look at the green meter grow. That's your friendship meter. When your friendship grows enough, the button in the middle of the circle pops up. Click it to ask your question.
What did the mayo say to the refrigerator door? Close the door, I'm dressing!
Holy moly, that's hysterical!
We're having meatloaf surprise today for lunch. It's like, surprise, this isn't really meat.
Love you more.
So, Tia, I want you to picture yourself in front of all those TV cameras.
Okay, I'm seeing it.
What do you think?
I think I look good.
Well, that's a given. And just think how hot you'll look when people watch you donating all your prize money to the fund to help children.
All the big rock stars help children. It's very hip, very today. Okay, I'll do it.
Now try it with Courtney.
Hey, you.
Hey, Barbie.
What do you call a sleeping bull? A bulldozer!
Ha! Love it!
No flies on you, you big smart genius.
I think it's because I ate a breakfast complete with all the essential vitamins and minerals.
I know we're supposed to feel the burn in gym class, but these rope burns are killing me.
I'd sure like to tell the coach to eat my gym shorts.
Courtney, you've been wanting some new accessories for your drum kit, right?
If I played the trumpet, I'd say, you're darn tootin'.
That means yes?
If I were a trucker, I'd say 10-4, good buddy.
How about if you were just a normal high school girl?
I'd say there's no such thing as normal.
Courtney, work with me here. Will you play in Battle of the Bands with me?
Okay, then. Yes, sure, certainly, abso-freaking-lutely! You know what would be so cool? You should make a documentary about our road to the Battle of the Bands, since you're on the school news crew, Barbie.
Yeah, a rockumentary! We're great subjects for a film. We're smart, talented, photogenic, harmonious.
Not to mention, incredibly modest. Well, I love the idea, but I've never been the subject of my own documentary before. How'd we even film it?
You could ask Kevin to do it.
But he's got so many other projects, who knows if he'd have time to be our cameraman.
Barbie, Kevin's so into you, he'd jump to be your garbage man.
Okay, I'll go ask him.
See the pulsing camera icon? That lets you know your current task. And when you finish a task, a new objective will pulse, and you'll hear this sound. Click the icon to learn what you need to do now. Try it. Go to the computer classroom to see Kevin. Follow the arrow to guide you there.
So, what's the dish?
Occasionally, you'll see objects with a twinkly star over them. Whenever you see something twinkle, you can click it to discover something new. Give it a click.
So what is it that young people do for fun?
Look who it is!
Barbie!
I think I could use about 12 hours more sleep.
I was thinking the same thing myself.
Why did the cowboy buy a dachshund? Because he wanted to get along, little doggy?
Smart and funny. I love this girl.
I didn't finish my science homework, but I'm hoping to get some credit for the creativity of my excuse.
Barbie, you're so smart, you don't even need to do homework.
Kevin, the girls and I want to make a documentary about Charmz and our road to the Battle of the Bands.
Cool. That's a movie I'd pay to see.
Well, you wouldn't have to pay, exactly.
And what do you mean by that exactly?
I was thinking you could film it for us.
You want me to be your cameraman?
Could you please?
So that's a yes?
Yes!
You know, I like the sound of that. Okay, I'm in.
Kevin, what did I do to deserve a friend like you?
You must have been very good in another life. Probably rescued puppies, healed the sick, something like that.
Or mastered bribery. Anyway, I think the first thing we'll want to film is the Battle of the Bands meeting for all the musicians at lunch.
You're sure it's okay if I come?
Of course! You're with the band!
Great. I've always wanted to be a groupie.
Dare to dream, Kevin. Dare to dream.
Okay, Barbie. Let's shoot your competition.
That's a little harsh, don't you think?
Very cute. But seriously, we should start the film by introducing all the main characters.
Okay. Well, we already know my bandmates in Charmz, Tia and Courtney, and Courtney's standing next to Cole, the guy she has a huge big crush on.
Kinda looks like he's been crushed by something huge and heavy.
That's just his style. He feels things very deeply. Anyway, there's Todd, football team captain and lead singer of Count Jocula. Next to Todd is his girlfriend Raquel, and her friends, Dawn and Reagan, members of the Populazzi.
Those girls play in a band?
No, just on the insecurities of others. And there's Mrs. Baez, who's running the show.
They let her take charge of this?
So she's a little high maintenance.
Barbie, if she were any higher maintenance, she'd be a rosebush. Well, okay, don't just stand there. Let's officially meet your frenemies.
Gossip!
I learned Todd loves pizza. At Todd's
party. It's in your best interest to tell me more.
You're such a visionary. I'll bet you can see through lockers.
True. I'm what you call a muse.
What did the bee say to the rose? Hey, bud!
Okay, I have to admit it. That was a good one.
That history class is so boring. I envy those dead presidents.
Cutting was made for her class.
He is fixing up my car. That's good scoop. Can I have another?
What's your poison?
After I rescued it from the jungle. Give me a moment. I'm going through caffeine withdrawal.
Huh. I'd like to hear more about that.
If I don't get it,
are you or have you ever been a gossip monger?
I learned Mrs. Baez likes coffee.
What makes you say that?
Right away, I worry that it would affect his dancing ability.
I learned Dawn hates zits. I learned Raquel likes Todd.
What's your
plan? Tell me something. I'm trying to figure out the plan for getting out of math class.
Okay.
I'd like to hear more about that.
For some reason, I'm a...
I learned Cole likes t-shirts with funny sayings on them.
Do you... Todd, tell me what you're doing.
I learned Cole likes yoga. I learned Neil hates getting stuffed in a locker.
Is it true what I
heard? Do you believe it? I felt so bad when Todd got injured at that game.
That's old stuff.
Ooh, I want something more.
Right away, I worried how it would affect his dancing ability at the prom.
I said the good word.
Yes.
It's the fashion police, and they're coming to get you. Is it true what I heard about you?
I've been listening to Babs's new album of show tunes. It's perfection on a disc.
Ooh, I want to hear more.
For our Battle of the Bands rockumentary, will you say your name for the camera and tell me which band you think is going to win and why?
I'm Todd, lead guitar god of Count Jocula, and we're going to win, because I always win.
What do whales use to hold their tails up? Blubber bands!
Stop it! You're killing me!
I usually like health class, but when we learned how hot dogs are made, I almost lost my lunch.
Cool!
Can I adopt you?
Tell me more!
Inquiring minds want to know, what makes you tick?
Strumming on the old six string.
That was pretty interesting. And interesting stuff interests me.
I can do so. Keep talking.
It's true. It's the fashion police, and they're coming to get you.
Quit pestering me about it, okay?
Are you ever been a gossip monger?
Not that I really care, but what's the lowdown?
Freshman day is really scary for ninth graders.
That's actually sort of interesting. Keep talking.
My older brother protected me during the day, but when we got home, he told me he'd just been saving the best for last.
Hey, can you introduce yourself to the camera and tell us who's gonna win Battle of the Bands and why?
My name is Cole. I'm in the band Time Out Boy. And I don't know who's gonna win, but if I were the type of person who voted, which I'm not, I'd vote for me.
Cole, you practice yoga, don't you?
Yeah, I feel like it helps me connect with my inner chi.
Is that anything like your inner ear?
It's more like your center.
You mean like your belly button?
Why do I even bother?
What sound do porcupines make when they kiss? Ouch!
Normally, I don't do the laughter thing, but that's funny.
You're so fashion-forward, it's like you're from the future.
My father told me I looked like a misfit, but I'm glad you appreciate my look.
Don't you just love t-shirts with funny sayings on them?
Oh, yeah. Wait a minute. Were you being funny by saying that?
Dawn's mom was so angry that she missed curfew. She took away her car, her cell phone, her pager, her television, and her computer. I mean, she might as well have taken away her purpose for living while she was at it, too.
Really? That's sick. But, like, in a good way.
Okay, pop quiz. What's your favorite thing to do when you're not in school?
Chasing storm clouds.
Give me the lowdown. What do I need to know here?
So I hear you're the one who does that thing.
Todd is way into me, so that takes up a lot of my time.
What's it all about?
He can't really.
I learned Reagan doesn't like to debate.
Look at me.
Hey, can you introduce yourself to the camera and tell us who's gonna win Battle of the Bands and why?
Hello, people. You all know me already, but I'm Raquel, and I think Todd's going to win because he's my boyfriend.
Picture the yearbook. What's the one thing you'll want to be remembered for?
I'm really excellent at telling people why their outfits don't work.
For our Battle of the Bands rockumentary, will you say your name for the camera and tell me which band you think is going to win and why?
Hi, I'm Reagan. I'm not in a band, so I don't really know, but Raquel wants everyone to vote for Todd.
What makes a cookie sad?
Feeling crummy. Normally, I'm only supposed to laugh at Raquel's jokes, but that was really funny.
Did you see what they're serving at the caf? I think they should change the name from menu to PU.
I heard we get served one category lower than prison food.
What would you say is your pet project?
Scooping vanilla ice cream. I love it, I love it, I love it!
Oh, that's juicy. And now you've made me hungry for more. I mean, seriously, look at my jeans. They're all the rage this season.
Give me a moment. I'm going through caffeine withdrawal.
Really?
If I don't get a couple of...
For our Battle of the Bands rockumentary, will you say your name for the camera and tell me which band you think is going to win and why?
I'm Dawn, and I think Todd's band Count Jocula is going to win. And I think that because that's what Raquel told me to think.
Ugh, I think I'm getting a pimple.
I got a zit once and it made me so mad.
What did you do?
I wore a bandage around my head. Tried to convince people the mummy look would be big next fall.
If you could teach a class on your best subject, what would it be about?
I love making smelly candles. Smelly good, I mean.
Attention! Attention, everyone! So glad you'll all be participating in our most exciting Battle of the Bands ever! The winner of this competition will play at the televised Summer Music Festival, so we want our school to look good! Therefore, I'll help you build the basics of your stage set. But you need to come down to the practice room and clean up your areas first. So, allegro, allegro, my little maestros. Time is music!
Is it true what I heard about you? I'm trying to figure out the equation for getting out of math class.
Ooh, tell me something interesting.
Thanks for helping, Barbie. These boxes are in the way if we want to build our stage sets here. To clean up this area, push the colored boxes into their same colored spaces. Try it now. Using the arrow keys, walk to the back side of the purple colored box. Great. Now push the right arrow key to get Barbie in her pushing position. Excelente! You're in the pushing position. Now press the arrow key in the same direction again to push the box. Great! Now push any other arrow key to make Barbie stand up. Now that you know how to move about and push the boxes, get to work and push all the colored boxes into the matching colored spaces. Good luck!
This is hard work. Almost there. A strong woman is a beautiful woman. Good thing I've been working out. Feels like I'm building muscles on muscles. Phew! I think I can. Look out, Hercules! I don't have to go to the gym today. Talk about girl power! Phew! Look at me go! Feels like I'm building muscles on muscles. Look out, Hercules! This is hard work. A strong woman is a beautiful woman. Phew! Look at me go! Good thing I've been working out. I don't have to go to the gym today. I think I can. Talk about girl power. Phew. Almost there. I don't have to go to the gym today. Phew!
Well done, Barbie! Looks like you have the strength of an ox!
Yeah, I'm just hoping I don't have the smell of one. Anyway, you'll help us fix up our set now, right?
I'll put together the basics, yes. If you want to make it super spiffy, though, there are some books in the library with decorating ideas. Miss Stewie will tell you where they are.
Awesome. Thanks for the tip, Mrs. Baez. I'll go to the library now and get one of those books.
Is it true what I heard about you?
Well, I guess you could... call me Artsy Fancy Candy.
Ooh, I want to hear more.
I see every blank space and white wall as a canvas.
Hi there.
Howdy-do, Barbie.
What nut sounds like a sneeze?
A cashew! That was terribly witty.
Someone took their smart pills this morning.
All the reading really does pay off.
Inquiring minds want to know, what makes you tick?
What's that you say? Can't hear you. I have my earplugs in. Headphones and earplugs are my salvation, I must say.
Miss Dewey?
Barbie, please, lower your voice.
Right, sorry. Miss Dewey?
Too loud! Too loud!
Okay. Miss Dewey?
What? Speak up, girl. I can't hear you.
What would you say is your pet project?
I read a lot of self-help books. I just can't help myself.
Picture the yearbook. What's the one thing you'll want to be remembered for?
Knitting. Because it's a ball of fun. Just like me.
My real workout in gym is trying to figure how to get out of class.
Exercising the mind is far more important.
You're good at knitting, right, Miss Dewey?
Take a look at my knitted brow and you tell me.
Hey, Miss Dewey, where can I find that set design book thingy?
Ah, yes, Barbie. Mrs. Baez's set decorating book. Well, I had it here somewhere. I must have misplaced it while I was restacking books. I know it has a red cover, and I was using my step stool to put it back on a shelf. Maybe someone else saw where I placed it, so you may ask around quietly. But remember, this talking in the library is a one-time occurrence.
Hi.
What's up?
Okay, pop quiz. What's your favorite thing to do when you're not in school?
Well, Barbie, you know I'm unhealthily obsessed with my car.
Courtney, are you still thinking of putting camouflage seat covers in your car?
No. I realized if I covered my car in camouflage, I might have trouble finding it.
What do you call a sheep with no legs?
A cloud! Oh my god, you just made me snort!
Did you see where Miss Dewey was stacking books earlier?
I saw her standing on a step stool, stacking books on a top shelf. So I'd look for that step stool.
Great! Now I have to get back to Mrs. Baez. I learned Milo like spiders.
What do you think?
I don't know. Looks kind of blah to me. No offense, Mrs. B.
Well, your ungrateful friend here is very rude. But she does have a point. That's why the design book you just picked up should be of great use to you. And to make your set extra jazzy, you should ask some of your creative classmates for help, too.
Oh, yeah, let's ask Candy.
The girl who decorates lockers?
Yeah, I love how she decorates lockers. I'm dying for her to do up mine. Maybe you could ask her to decorate a banner with our band's name on it.
That's a great idea, Tia. I'll go find her and ask if she'll do it.
Ooh, yes! And you might also want to ask Neil to hang some stars from your set. And Cole will add pizzazz with wall panels. Of course, you know Dawn is a brilliant butterfly designer. And Raquel can make a groovy rainbow skirt to finish off the stage.
Wow, I need to write all that down in my diary so I don't forget who does what and who I can ask for help. Then I'll find Candy and beg her to make us a kick-butt banner. Okay, girls, off I go. See you after school for practice.
Now tell me what it is that makes you, you.
It's hard to be famous.
Fascinating.
Hey!
Hey, girl!
Hey! Did you hear about the corduroy pillows? They're making headlines!
Barbie! That is too funny!
I can't wait till Friday.
I feel you.
If you could teach a class on your best subject, what would it be about?
I'm all about the artwork.
For science lab, we have to analyze sludge. Apparently, just saying it's stuff you scrape off your shoe isn't good enough.
Me too.
Candy, the artwork you do just shines.
The secret is covering everything in a layer of glitter. But tell you the truth, I use so much of it, I sneeze sparkles.
Wow, that was a lot of information. Anyway, I'm hoping you could help me create something dazzling.
You've come to the right bedazzler. I'm a pistol with a glue gun. What can I do you for?
Think you could help me decorate the Charmz banner?
Easy peasy. Ooh, maybe I'll use peas. And when I'm finished with this special candy creation, you can look for it in the practice room.
Don't let me forget, Diary. Mrs. Baez told me I could ask some of the other students to help me decorate the set, and I can ask for their help whenever I want.
To look at what other additions you can make to your set and who can help you make them, just click on the Charm Stage tab in the diary. Try it now. Good. Close the diary to continue the game.
Hey, Kevin.
Hi, Kev.
Hi, Barbie.
Hello.
Sorry, Court. I didn't see you there.
Blinded by the blondness, eh?
Yeah. I've got my camera. You guys are still planning to practice, right?
Of course. We're just waiting for Tia. Why?
Well, a bunch of other bands just dropped out of the competition.
Really? Do you know why?
Come on, Barbie. Would you want to compete against this?
Hey, guys. Sorry I'm late, but I'm a little frazzled.
You ran out of styling gel?
Bite your tongue? No, look at the text I got during sixth period today.
Charmz girls, drop out of Battle of the Bands now or else.
Or else? I'm not scared of no stinking or else. Or else what?
Ah! Someone vandalized our set!
It must have happened in the 5 minutes I left to get my lunch! I can help you start to rebuild it.
I have to find out who did this.
No, Barbie. You stay here and rebuild. I'll go do some investigating.
Okay, this isn't too bad. Just like Humpty Dumpty, we can put the pieces back together again.
Dumpy? Who are you calling Dumpy?
Tia, it's just an expression, I swear.
To put the stage back together again, click and drag the pieces to their correct location on the picture above.
Now that we've fixed the set, we need to sort out our music if we're gonna hit any high notes with our performance. All right, girls, let's stay focused and try to practice now. Holy high notes! Our sheet music's been torn into a million little pieces!
And check it out. That crazy vandal even changed the order of the notes on some of the pages, too.
That's lower than a bass baritone.
But when I find out who did this, I'll make him sing soprano. Okay, I'll worry about getting the notes back in order later. But first thing to do now is to put the pieces back together.
Click and drag a piece to move it. Also, you can hold the space bar down and click a piece to rotate it. Try it now.
Now that the sheet music's pieced back together, it's time to meet Kevin at my house to see if he's gotten any good camera moments.
Good news, Barbie. I have some very incriminating evidence.
Kevin, that's great!
Of 6 different people.
Nice work, detective. But it's a start. Okay, what do you got?
I stink! Count Jocula will never win Battle of the Bands. Unless all the other bands mysteriously quit.
I have to face facts.
Yeah, your fake tan does make you look like a tangerine.
Not that banana brain. I'm talking about how badly Todd plays guitar.
That was a guitar? I thought that was the sound of him kicking a cat.
I cannot let my boyfriend embarrass himself like this.
And embarrass you by extension.
And us by an extension to the extension. What can we do?
Don't worry, girls. I have a plan.
That math test was so hard, it almost made me cry.
Cole, why didn't you come to me for help? You know I'd do anything for you.
You taped Courtney?
Well, she said she'd do anything to help Cole. And he's your competition, too.
Todd's a much more likely suspect.
Agreed. So we just need him to say something incriminating on tape. Think you can plant this camera in Count Jocula's practice area?
You bet. I'll make that count accountable. Well, Diary, Kevin did some good work yesterday, and now I've got a list of 6 suspects who may be behind this Battle of the Bands mystery. Dawn, Reagan, and Raquel, Natch. Cole and Courtney, who I refuse to believe is guilty. And Todd. Todd's my number one suspect. So today, I'll sneak into Count Jocula's practice and plant a hidden camera. Okay, what should I wear so I won't get noticed? Wow, I've never said that before.
Choose tops. Choose pants. Pick a color for your pants. Pick a color for your...
Very cool choice. Come on, come on. You don't want to be late. Here goes. I'm going to sneak like a fox, be as shady as a tree, and hope when I plant this camera, they don't see me. I need to place this camera in a spot where it won't be seen, so I have to sneak through this maze of objects to get there without getting seen myself either.
This is a restricted area, okay? No losers allowed.
Trying to spy on your competition, are you? I don't think so. You out!
Hey, I spy with my little eye a Barbie. Now shoo, fly.
This is a restricted area, okay? No losers allowed.
Let's see what sort of evidence we get now. Bet you Todd winds up incriminating himself on this tape.
Normally I don't gamble, but I will bet Todd doesn't know what the word incriminating means.
Ah, he's going to make my ears bleed!
He is pretty bad.
Hey, that's my boyfriend you're talking about.
I think someone might want to tell Todd playing with his tongue is a bad call.
Look, Miss Thing, I don't care if you are some prodigy musician. Todd has his own style.
But I just thought...
Thinking was your first mistake. So why don't you call someone who cares? Anyway, Todd's going to win this battle of the bands because I don't date losers.
You used to.
Not helping.
A little help?
Todd, what happened?
Ever since I got injured playing football last week, I'm hobbling around like an old man.
You'll be better by prom, right?
I hope so.
Oh, you better. Because if I wanted to dance with a lame-o, I'd go with that big nerd Neil.
Wait a sec. If Todd's been injured, he couldn't have snuck in, vandalized the sets, and snuck out in the short amount of time Mrs. Baez was away from the room.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying even if Todd did know what incriminating himself meant, he still wouldn't have been able to do it. Since Todd couldn't have wrecked our set because of his bum leg, I can cross him off my list of suspects, but I still have no clue who's behind this. Okay, Diary, I need to ask who saw what, who heard who, and demand answers. That sounded pretty tough, didn't it? Since I'm in the library, though, I'm not supposed to be talking at all. I'll just have to ask my questions super sneakily so Miss Dewey doesn't see me, because if I get caught, she'll throw the book at me.
Use the arrow buttons to move Barbie around the library to chat with other students, but you'll need to watch out for Miss Dewey so she doesn't catch you talking. If you see her coming while you're asking questions, wait until she leaves to begin talking again.
If you could teach a class on your best subject, what would it be about?
I'm a take-charge kind of a girl, Barbie, so I take charge of everything, all the time.
I heard Ms. Ronkonkoma became a teacher because she liked torturing children.
Cutting was made for her class.
Why don't robots panic? Because they have nerves of steel?
Wow, Barbie. This may be the first time I'm laughing with you instead of at you.
Zip the lip, zip the lip, zip the lip. Talk about a tongue twister.
Raquel, you and Todd make a great couple.
It's true, and I never fail to remind him how lucky he is to have me.
So, do you think anyone has the motive to mess up Battle of the Bands?
Just Courtney, because she literally said to me, if Cole doesn't win Battle of the Bands, he'll get even more depressed.
No way! That can't be right!
I know! It's like, how could he get more depressed?
Talkers are not welcome here. Goodbye.
Hey, Raquel, don't you just love Reagan's outfit today?
No, I happen to hate it.
You do, but it's so cute.
I know. And that's exactly the problem. She almost looks cuter than me.
Talk to me about the Vandals.
They're like the hottest rock band on the scene these days.
No, not those Vandals. I mean, who do you think vandalized my stage set?
Oh, Courtney.
Hey, you didn't see anything suspicious going on by the practice room around lunchtime, did you?
Yeah, I saw Courtney and Cole walking together and she said, quote, "You know I'd do anything for you."
But that doesn't sound like her.
Okay, so maybe it was more like, "You know I'd do anything for you."
So what if Courtney had a free period when our set was vandalized? So what if she told Cole she'd do anything to help him? So what if she's known for her wild side? So what am I going to do if my friend's guilty? I have to go talk to her and find out what's up. I think she's getting out of math about now. I learned Courtney doesn't like math. What's up?
Hiya!
Courtney, you really like Cole, don't you?
Like him? Ha! Like doesn't even cover the half of it. Try using the words obsessed with instead.
So, is it fair to say you'd be willing to do, like, anything for him?
Barbie, if he asked me to cut my hair, I'd probably do it.
Whoa. And you pretty much want him to succeed at everything he does, right?
It's not just that I want him to succeed, it's that I think he deserves to.
Oh, well, do you think he deserves to win Battle of the Bands?
Unbelievable!
What's unbelievable?
Barbie thinks I destroyed our sets, rearranged the notes in our music, and sent that creepy text because I'm trying to impress Cole.
No, I don't, but...
But I can't believe it even entered that bleach blonde head of yours!
Courtney, first of all, I'm just trying to solve this mystery. And second of all, I am totally a natural blonde.
You know what? Forget it. And forget you.
Barbie, accusing your friend like this is so uncool. Even if she is guilty.
Come on, Tia. Let's you and me go where we know we're appreciated.
The mall?
That's not exactly what I meant, but whatever. We're out of here.
Yeah! We can go to the mall later, right?
Come on, Tia!
This is terrible. I never meant to accuse my friends of anything. Oh, great. Tia left her handheld. If it hadn't been for the message she got on this stupid thing sent from who knows where... Wait a sec. I bet Neil could help me trace where this message came from and who sent it. And as soon as I know that, the mystery will be solved. Now all I have to do is convince Neil to help me. And figuring out how to do that is a mystery in itself. I learned Mr. Fermat likes spy novels. Hey-ya.
Hello, Barbie.
What do you call a flying skunk? A smellicopter.
Wow. I didn't know girls had senses of humor.
I think it's interesting that so much of civics is about people being uncivil.
The pursuit of knowledge isn't always pretty, but it is necessary.
I can tell you're the type of person who colors outside the lines.
I've always seen myself as an innovator.
Neil, I heard you got stuffed in a locker the other day.
Yeah, well, you should have seen what happened to the other guy.
What happened to the other guy?
I don't know. I couldn't see. I was inside the locker, remember?
Neil, I know how good you are with computers.
Everyone knows that, Barbie. Gosh, it's not like it's a secret.
No, that's true. But I was wondering if your computer expertise extended to these little handheld devices, too.
Naturally. I'm what you call the master of multi-domain.
So, do you think you can help me figure out where this text message to Tia came from?
Can I? Or will I?
Oh, I'm sure you can. Now, will you?
Well, since you're smart enough to recognize my genius, yeah, okay, I'll help you.
Starting from the handheld, click on a square to turn the line within it. Then, turn the lines in other squares to connect them in a path back down to the sender. Click ready.
Okay, Barbie, I need your help to trace this message. I've located the position of the handheld, but I need you to connect the handheld to the question mark so we can find out where the message is coming from. I'll keep the connection open as long as I can. It is. The message came from the library.
LIB312. What does that mean?
LIB312 is the name of the computer terminal in the library.
So who sent the message?
Well, we know it was sent at 1:42 p.m., but since the message came from a public computer, it's impossible to say who sent it.
Rats. But wait a minute. 1:42 p.m. is smack in the middle of sixth period, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's when Courtney and Cole have math.
So?
So, that day they were taking a test. And it would have been impossible for either one of them to have snuck into the library and sent a message while they were taking a timed test.
But you still don't know who sent the message.
I know. But almost more importantly, I do know it definitely wasn't sent by my friend. The good news is I can cross Courtney and Cole off the suspect list. The bad news is, I think Courtney and Tia have crossed me off their friendship list. I have to apologize to them, Diary. Otherwise, I'm gonna spend the rest of high school talking to myself. Maybe I should leave a note in their lockers. Wait! Tia wants her locker decorated, so I need to ask Candy to help me do it upright. Can't go to school in my PJs.
I need to try on some kind of stuff today.
Okay, I need to find Candy so she can give me stickers to decorate Tia's locker. And speaking of Candy, I'm getting a little hungry.
Hey, you!
What's the word, Barbie?
I actually heard Todd use the line, "Baby, you must be tired because you keep running through my mind."
Ooh, tell me more, tell me more!
Candy, you make people's lockers look so cool, you almost forget it's the place they hide their detention slips.
Thanks, Barbie. As an artist, I try to make the world a more colorful place, one locker at a time.
Well, speaking of color, I've been kind of blue lately myself.
Ooh, that's bad. Blue doesn't look good on you.
My friends are mad at me.
That bites.
Yeah, but I was thinking since Tia is dying to get her locker decorated, if you could give me some of the stickers you use, I could try to make things up to her.
That's a really smart idea. I'm sure she'll love it too. So here are the stickers. Good luck and have fun! Here are some of my favorite stickers, Barbie. Just click and drag them onto the locker. Nice. 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 Great choice! Great choice! Great choice! Great choice!
Barbie, did you do this to my locker?
Well, that depends. Do you like it?
Do I like it? It's amazing! A million thanks, Bee. You are one great friend.
Oh, I'm so glad to hear you say that! Now I just need to make things cool again with Courtney.
She's a big link in our friendship chain.
Tia, you just gave me the best idea!
Well, happy to help. What did I do?
You said chain, which reminded me that Courtney has always wanted a friendship necklace, so I'm gonna make her one.
That's a fantastic idea. I'm glad I came up with it. You know, I have a bunch of beads from crafts class, so let's grab a table in the courtyard and I'll help you make it.
Tia, how do I love thee? Let me count the ways.
Let's make Courtney's name first. Click and drag the correct letters into the flashing squares. Find the C. Very good. Find the O. Nice job. Find the U.
Terrific.
Find the R. Looks like you know your letters. Find the T.
Keep going.
Find the N.
Good.
Almost done. Find the
E. Very good.
Find the Y.
Very good.
Courtney is going to love this. Now click and drag any beads you want into the remaining squares to complete the necklace. Let's see how creative you are, Barbie.
Barbie, I love my necklace. Thanks.
I'm so happy you like it.
I totally do. And I like it even more that we got everything straightened out.
That's right. No more tangles.
Okay, girlies, if we want to win Battle of the Bands tomorrow...
And we do.
We so do.
Then we've got to get our groove on.
And get the beat back.
And, like, practice. So let's get down to business and play.
But we have one final problem. Don't forget, our music was rearranged.
But we've already fixed our stage set and put the sheets of music back together. So a few rearranged notes aren't going to stop us.
I have the songs recorded on my music player. Let's listen to them so we can arrange everything back to its original composition and learn the songs as we go. Here are the songs we need to learn. Click Ready to begin. Click the triangle button to hear the song we need to learn. Now click each of the arrow buttons under the musical notes to hear the song parts. Now click and drag each sheet of music to the space where you think it belongs. When you think you have the right order, click the play button to see how you did. Correctly placed music will flash green. Incorrectly placed music will flash red and go back to the top. Play the song again to figure out the proper order. When you complete a song correctly, you move up to the next level. Good luck! If you're finished, click the Done button. You can come. The good news is that the band is back together and sounding great. The bad news is no one will get to hear us unless I catch this Battle of the Bands bungler. Okay, I've narrowed the suspect list down to Dawn, Reagan, and Raquel. Now I just need to know which of them can read music. because only someone who knows how to do that could have rearranged our notes. I never thought I'd say this, but fortunately those girls spend so much time talking about themselves, someone will know the deal. And I'll bet that someone is Todd. He's probably tossing a football on the popular lawn right now, so that's where I'll go next.
Is it true what I heard about you?
Does everyone know about my crush?
Tell me what you're talking about. I don't care if Tia does have an alibi. She's our vandal.
I learned Coach Paternal likes exercise.
She did the crime. Now she should do
the I learned Coach Paternal likes eating a lot.
You're the one who does that thing.
One of my specialties is making people do what I want.
What's it all about?
Okay. You and I are done with this discussion. Now, move along. I said move!
Hi!
Sup?
I'm not saying the food in the cafeteria is bad. I'm saying when it walks off your plate, it's a bad sign.
You said a mouthful, Blondie.
Why did the cow cross the road? To get to the other side.
That's totally funny.
Todd, I have a question for you.
The answer's yes. I do look like this when I wake up in the morning.
Amazing.
Thank you.
Listen, Todd, I need to ask you something else.
Oh, sorry, Barbie. No time.
This won't take very long, I promise.
I can't be late for practice.
You just need to tell me if Dawn, Reagan, and Raquel can read music.
Coach Paternal said last one to practice has to clean mouth guards with his toothbrush. So I got a jet, which is gonna be hard enough with my injury.
Well, you shouldn't be going to practice, should you? I mean, you're actually hurt, right?
Well, yeah, but I'm too scared to ask Coach if I can miss practice.
If I can convince Coach Paternal to let you skip practice, will you answer my questions?
You bet! And here's a tip to sweeten Coach up. He loves chocolate hyper bars.
Do you believe what that spook tried to pull off?
I'm a critic.
There's a spy in our midst.
Okay, hit me again.
No respect. What else you do?
Excellent. Criticizing people.
But the vice principal's working as a double agent.
I hear Barbie's
band is
trying
to
outcompete
the new principal?
Don't.
Is that all?
The water.
But it'll never happen because
did you hear any reports from the teachers at his last school? My sources tell me you know who has put you know what in it.
Look who it is.
Well, look what the cat dragged in.
When we were at a Chinese restaurant and I dropped lo mein in my lap, my dad said, "Well, Barbie, dinner's on you."
Ha!
I've been practicing for the mile run in gym class by doing laps in the mall.
I know you're kidding about that, which is why we could share a good laugh over it.
Coach,
There's no I in team, Barbie. Run that one through your head. In fact, why don't you run a few laps for me right now? Exercise. Learn it. Live it. Love it.
You're a doll.
You just made my day.
Hey, Coach, I have a few extra French fries. Want them?
French fries? No way.
You don't like French fries?
I only eat American food, Barbie.
Coach Paternal, you wouldn't want an injured athlete to go to practice, would you?
You're assuming the person is really injured.
Well, yeah, he has a bad leg.
And how do you know that? Do you have X-ray vision?
No.
Then how do you know the person isn't faking?
Because Todd loves playing football, and I can't imagine why he'd want to fake an injury.
Oh, you're talking about Todd. Well, I know he's injured. I'm the one who injured him at the last game. unintentionally, of course. But I can't really make any decisions now. Low blood sugar, you see. Tell you what, give me a candy bar, I'll owe you one.
I need the who, the where, the why, and the what.
I can't wait for freshman day. I get to show those little kids who's boss.
You might not be a total waste of time.
I learned Todd has a lot to say about cops.
Take away the teacher's lounge.
Every day is like freshman day for me.
Is that so?
Well,
I need more information to go on. What the that? We did.
One of my specialties is making people do what I want.
Okay, hit me again.
What makes you say that? Okay, you and I are done with this discussion. Move along. Before they started handling snakes.
Is it true what I heard about you?
So you saw my car? It's right. I've spent like a ton of time detailing it.
I want to hear more.
I know it's not such a girly thing to do, but who cares? I love it, love it, love it!
Offer the hyper bar to Coach, and maybe he'll help you.
Interesting. Me? I'm into decorating.
So if doing push-ups isn't your thing,
okay,
what is?
Now tell me more.
No time to talk. The detective in my spy novel is about to reveal the assassin.
But does it build up her body strength?
You know, my guess?
I wouldn't say
it was the vice president. Never trust a former ninja.
No way!
What's up?
Hello there, young lady!
Here you go, Coach. So will you let Todd out of practice now?
Yeah. I think that could be rings.
Fantastic! Thanks!
My pleasure.
So Dawn can't carry a tune?
Not even with a wheelbarrow. When she was learning how to play an instrument in the fourth grade, she was so bad the teacher only let her practice rests.
She can't read music at all?
She's so musically illiterate, I'm surprised she can play the radio.
Wait, what about Reagan and Raquel?
Super hot.
No, I mean, can either one of them read music?
Oh, yeah, of course, both.
So Reagan or Raquel could still be guilty.
Look, you didn't hear it from me, but let's just say they're both players, and I should know.
Okay, Dawn's gone, and now that I've crossed her off the list, there are only two suspects left, Raquel and Reagan. Did either girl have the time, skill, and motivation to be such a player-hating meanie? I bet some of the jesters in the courtyard will know.
Pick a color for choose pants. Choose, pick a color, choose, choose, pick a color.
Yeah!
Let's go!
That looks pretty good! Hey!
Hey, Barbie girl!
What would you say is your pet project?
I'm huge into activism, so if I can act up about something, you bet I will!
I told our Western Civ teacher that there was no point in doing the homework since the subject was already history.
You have much more important things to worry about, like us practicing for Battle of the Bands!
Ask if anyone saw Raquel in the library.
How long have you considered yourself a student activist?
Well, you know me. I've always liked to be involved.
I remember that even in kindergarten, you lobbied for longer nap times.
That's right. A girl needs her beauty rest, Barbie, and someone just had to say it.
Hey, did you spy Raquel in the library sixth period on Monday?
Raquel was there. I saw her check out a book on mind control. I can't think of why, but I don't trust that girl.
Mrs. Baez is going to be too happy with some of
I learned Tia knows her fashion.
Keep spilling.
No one's going to be playing any show tunes.
So I hear you're the one who does that thing.
I made it to level 7 of Battleship Star Warriors.
What's it all about?
Now, I don't think anyone else in this entire school has even gotten past, like, level 3.
Hey,
Barbie, baby, what's up?
Now ask if Reagan could have been in the library, too.
What's a baby's favorite ride? A stroller coaster.
I'm going to put your name in the dictionary under the word funny.
Yeah, and her commitment to fighting hunger is even more attractive.
Hi there.
What do you want, Barbie?
Any chance you saw Reagan on Monday in the library during sixth period?
Yeah, and even though you're not supposed to talk in the library, Reagan still found a way to mock me.
Okay, since both Raquel and Reagan were in the library at the same time the message was sent, there's no news there. But if I can hack into the library computer log and find out who used the keyboard, the identity of our mysterious text messenger will be revealed.
Go to computer LIB312 in the library and hack into the computer log. Find out who logged on to this computer and sent the text message. Click the squares in the grid. Eliminate the matching letters to reveal the name of the vandal. Good luck! To delete a saved game. Click here to go back. Click here to delete a saved game. Click here.
I can't believe it was Reagan. I mean, why? I don't get it.
Which is exactly why I need to get the poop straight from the horse's mouth.
Reagan probably won't like being referred to as a horse.
Well, if the horseshoe fits.
Ask around to find Reagan. Hint, check the library.
I learned Neil is sweet on Tia. I learned Neil likes playing video games. I learned Milo likes plants. Just the person I wanted to see.
How's it going?
I heard Reagan was here, but I don't see her. Do you know where she is?
Reagan just split. You can probably catch her in the classroom hallway.
Reagan is in the classroom hallway. Go get the Battle of the Bands bungler.
I heard one of Cole's songs.
I see. So what's your take?
And it's true. None of his...
Hey, you! What's up? Reagan, you had the time, the expertise, and the opportunity to vandalize our sets.
Yeah, so what's your point?
So my point is that I think you're the person who's trying to ruin Battle of the Bands.
And
the jig is up!
The jig? FYI, Barbie, popular people don't use the word jig.
They don't?
No, that word is so 2003.
Oh. Well, it doesn't matter. Reagan, I'm just going to come out and ask you directly. Are you responsible for this?
One word, guilty as charged.
But Reagan, why?
Because I deserve to be the winner of that Battle of the Bands.
You weren't even in the competition, though.
I know. But I've been taking piano lessons and practicing every day since I was 3 years old.
So why didn't you sign up?
Because Raquel said I shouldn't. She knows how bad a musician Todd is, and she said I shouldn't compete against her boyfriend because she wanted him to win.
But if Raquel's your friend, why didn't you just explain to her how much it meant to you?
I did, and she told me that if I signed up, she'd banish me from her lunch table, and I'd have to eat with the mathletes.
I'm a mathlete.
Anyway, I just figured if I couldn't compete, I didn't want anyone else to be able to either.
Reagan, that's warped.
I guess. So, what should I do now?
Well, paying for the set damage you caused is a good start.
Okay.
And you could give me an exclusive interview for my next documentary, A Piano Prodigy Strikes All the Wrong Notes.
Deal.
Okay, we'll talk more about this later. Right now I've got practice, so I need to make like a drummer and beat it.
So that's how I figured out Reagan was the guilty party.
You're incredible, Barbie. We never doubted you as a super sleuth for even 1 minute.
Really?
Okay, maybe for 1 minute.
Well, now that the mystery's solved, we've got something even more important to do.
Oh no, we do?
Yeah, we need to get ready to rock and roll!
I was born ready. Let's show them what we've got.
Starlight, star bright, let Charmz shine tonight!
Yeah!
May the best band win!
And may that band be ours.
Okay, girls, let's pull out all the stops to blow this crowd away!
Wow, look at our stage! How do we use all this equipment?
Easy, just click a song to choose it.
What about the other stuff?
Well, to set up different camera shots or lighting, click on the appropriate buttons to use the camera or to zoom. And say you want to change the lighting design. Click on these buttons to use the spotlights, the colored lights, the laser lights, or the footlights. So let's have fun and show them what we've got. Though at first the Battle of the Bands competition seemed like it was in jeopardy, the only real danger last night came to our eardrums. But all turned out very well in the end, especially for one brilliant band, Charmz. Those girls were on fire, if I do say so myself. Charmz ultimately won over the crowd and won the competition. And because Charmz took first place, the three lucky bandmates will split the prize money and have qualified to play in this summer's televised music festival. But I want to congratulate everyone who participated and say you're all winners in my book. And stay tuned, because trust me, you haven't heard the last of us yet.
Click. Click here to exit the game.